Hello YouTube, it is Thursday, so today is time for another Photoshop CC tutorial. This is graphic designer Roberto Blake, and today we're going to be doing a glowing lines tutorial. So let's jump in. We're going to go ahead and select the pen tool, since this is what we're going to be using to make our vector-based lines for this glowing lines tutorial. We want to make sure that it's set to paths. We're going to create a new layer to go ahead and draw these paths on. And for the purposes of my photo, I'm just going to do some curved lines going around the clothing, around the legs and the arms here. But you can do whatever's going to look interesting for your photograph when you're doing this. Go ahead and make sure when you're doing this that the new layer is selected. And go ahead and plot your points and your curves however you want. Remember that if you use Alt and click on the anchor points, that you can control the direction of the curve a lot better, but sometimes you don't want to do that just because you'll get an interesting curve by default from Photoshop. And you're going to notice throughout this that when I want to go ahead and start a point elsewhere, that I'm just switching over to the direct selection tool, which is shortcut A. You're going to want to go ahead and use your direct selection tool to select the strokes that you've made or the points that you've made with the pen tool. And then you're going to switch back to the pen tool, right click, and use the option for stroke paths. You're going to stroke the paths, that's not meant to be a joke or a pun of any kind. But when you stroke the paths, that's going to be one of the first major steps to creating your glowing lines. Once you do that, you can do one of two things. You can either go ahead and... Actually, you can do anything you want, but in my case, you can either go ahead, once you've done that, and duplicate the paths that you made just to get kind of an interesting effect once you do this. And you can do those on a separate layer, or you can do them on the same layer, or you can go ahead and delete the paths so that you can go ahead and make completely new, fresh paths without having to worry about any overlap or intersection. But we'll get to that here. In a moment. As you can see, I'm still just creating individual paths here, preparing to go ahead and move to the next step of stroking these paths and adding our effect. When you're doing the stroking for the paths, you want to make sure you have simulate brush pressure selected, and you're going to want to make sure that before you go ahead and stroke your paths that you've adjusted your brush to the thickness and to the settings that you want. So just go ahead and do that. And then once we have those all selected here, we're going to go ahead and stroke our paths, making sure that we have the layer selected and the brush tool. All right. Now once you've stroked your paths, you can go to the layer options for the effects panel, and you're going to want to go ahead and select outer glow. You can also do some of this with inner glow. You can do whatever effects you like, but for the purposes of this tutorial, we'll do outer glow and select the color that we want, and we'll just go ahead and use a blend mode of either screen or color dodge. It just kind of depends on what your background needs when you're doing that. So just go ahead and work according to your photo's needs. In this case, we're just going to go ahead and do this. And also, if you adjust the range slider, you can go ahead and determine some other things about how this effect is going to look. But ultimately, this is how you achieve the basic look of glowing lines that you've seen in other photo manipulations and poster work, etc. This is how you do that. Now, there are some more things that I'm going to do in this tutorial, and there's some masking that can be done, but I'm going to do this as a two-part tutorial, but this is the main part for the glowing lines that you know, we wanted for this photo manipulation. And there's a lot of other cool things that we can do from here, but primarily, this is how you create the glowing lines. And based on what our photo is, obviously we're going to paint away certain things. And we'll get a little more into that into the second part of the tutorial, but you have the general basics here, and this is how we accomplish the primary effect. And then obviously you paint out what you don't want with masking. And if you haven't learned more about masking, or you want to learn more about masking, there is a tutorial that I have on this YouTube channel where I reference that. So you know, feel free to check that out. Do another layer where we have these paths. We'll select another color to use for this. We're just going to go with a red. And again, one of the other things you can do with this, just in terms of an extra shortcut, is if you wanted to, you can start by holding Alt while on the effects portion of the layer and drag that up to another layer, and it'll basically just duplicate the effects that you already have onto another layer, and that becomes something interesting in terms of a shortcut you can use. In the second part of the tutorial, I'm actually going to do a little more with this image. There's some additional effects that I want to add, some light sourcing, just different things, but I'll cover that in the second half of this tutorial, so stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like this video if you like it, and again, don't forget, this is in fact a two-part video, but you can get by with just the techniques I've shown you in this tutorial and do some really interesting things with that. All right, thanks for watching.